Good morning, students. In the previous class, we discussed about the effects, that is the inductive effect we have discussed, and the resonance effect or mesomeric effect we have discussed, and electromeric effect we have discussed in the previous classes. In this class, we are going to be discussing about the remaining effect, that is the hyperconjugation effect, and also we are discussed about the differences between these, that is the inductive effect and the mesomeric effect or resonance effect, or inductive effect and the electromeric effect. The first we will discuss about the differences between, there is a differences between the inductive effect and mesomeric effect. The first we are going to be discussing about the differences. That is differences between inductive and mesomeric effects. When comes to the differences between the inductive and mesomeric effect, the first column we write that is inductive effect. Second column we are going to read has a mesomeric effect. Mesomeric effect. That is the first one is inductive effect and the second one is mesomeric effect. The first one we are going to be discussing about the inductive effect means it involves the displacement of the sigma electrons. Inductive effect means involves displacement of this sigma electrons. Then in the mesomeric effect, it involves the displacement of the pi electrons. Means involves displacement of these pi electrons. This is about the first difference between the inductive and the mesomeric. In the second, that is the electrons are partially displaced in this case. That is the electrons are partially displaced. In this case, electrons are completely displaced. In the mesomeric effect, electrons are completely displaced. Next, it occurs in saturated system, then it occurs in the, that is, conjugated unsaturated system. It occurs in conjugated unsaturated system. Next, then it is going to be weakens when the distance is increases from the substituent group. Means it is going to be weakens, but it doesn't change. Does not change the effect when the distance is increased. The distance is increased, the inductive effect decreases, but this mesomeric effect does not be, that is, the result be weaker. Next, it is going to mean involves, that is, it does not involve the delocalization of the electrons, it involves the delocalization of the electrons. This is about the differences between the inductive effect and the mesomeric effect. Mesomeric effect and the inductive effect. The next we will discuss about the differences between the inductive effect and the electromeric effect. Now we will discuss about the differences between inductive and the electromeric effect. In the first column we will write that is inductive effect. Inductive effect. In the second column we can write as a electromeric effect. Electromeric effect. That is the inductive effect and the electromeric effect. The first one. It is the permanent effect. It is a temporary effect. That is, it is going to be permanent effect. This inductive effect is permanent effect. Permanent effect. Then electromeric effect is temporary effect. Temporary effect. This is about the temporary effect. Then, in the second difference is, involves the sigma electrons. Involves sigma electrons. And then, involves the pi electrons. This is about the second difference. It is essential, it does not essential the attacking reagent. Does not require attacking reagent. It is essential. This is the permanent effect. This is the temporary effect. It involves the sigma electrons. It involves the pi electrons. Does not require the attacking reagent. It's required essential for the attacking reagent and does not form ions. It forms ions. Then this is about the inductive effect. It does not form the ions, but in the electromeric effect, it is going to be forming. That is ions. Then the multiple bond is not essential in the inductive effect, and the multiple bond is essential in the electromeric effect. Next difference is multiple bond is not essential in inductive effect, but in the electromeric effect, multiple bond is essential. Multiple bond is essential. This is about the differences between the inductive and the electromeric effect. These are important because so many times has been the examination differences between either inductive effect and the mesomeric effect. Either they are going to be asking the inductive effect and the electromeric effect. The next we will discuss about the fourth type of effect, that is hyperconjugation. Next we are going to discussing about the hyperconjugation. This is the fourth one, that is the hyperconjugation. conjugation. It is a permanent effect. It is obtained by the displacement of the sigma electrons. That is the displacement of the sigma electron. This is a permanent effect. It is caused by the. It is caused by the. That is the displacement of the sigma electrons. That is donation of the electrons from the hydrogen atom which is attached to the carbon. So going to donation of the electrons in this effect, the donation of the electrons is going to be takes place. That is the hydrogen atom which is attached to the carbon-carbon double bond, which is adjacent to the carbon-carbon double bond. You can see an example. That is CH, then H, CH, double bond, CH2. We can see this example. In this, the displacement of these electrons is going to be takes place. Then it is going to be formed a canonical form. It's going to be used the some canonical form. That is a hydrogen CH plus double bond CH then CH2 minus. Means electron density is going to be increases here. Electron density is going to be increases. Means this also be called as a no bond resonance. It is also be called as a no bond resonance. Why? Means there is no bond. There is no bond in the, between the carbon and the hydrogen. The carbon and the hydrogen in the canonical form. Canonical form only yavade tara bond irodilla adukosrame idanna namu no bond resonance antanu karithivi. Also be called as a no bond resonance. This also be called as a no bond resonance. Yeah, this we can be written as like this also. Another canonical form also we can be written as, that is instead of this, this is going to be H plus, then H, H, then double bond, CH, CH2 minus, then H plus is there, and also etc. We can be written some other structures also. Means here the methyl group shows the maximum of this hyperconjugation effect because it is having the maximum hydrogen atoms. This in the methyl group, the carbon having the maximum hydrogen. Therefore, this hyperconjugation effect is going to be stabilizes the tertiary carbocation than the secondary. The secondary is more stabilized than the primary carbocation. Primary, that is carbocation, is more stabilized than the methyl group. That is the order of the carbocation is going to be like this. That is carbon atom which is attached to the three methyl groups is more stable due to the hyperconjugation than the secondary carbocation. That is the secondary carbocation. CH3 twice. Then this is more stable than the primary carbocation. That is the CH2 plus. Then these are more stabilizes due to hyperconjugation than the methyl carbocation. Means this is going to be how this is more stable. There is a dispersing of the positive charge. I like the structures. Suppose this they are going to be written as, this is about the structure of tertiary carbocation. structure of tertiary carbocation. In this, the displacing of one hydrogen, the displacing of this electrons of this hydrogen, then we are going to be get the structure. We are going to be get that the structure canonical form. We are going to be get that C double bond C H and H then H plus yeah then C H H H then C H H H. This is the one of the canonical form. There is no bond between the carbon and the hydrogen. Like this only again one more structure. Instead of this hydrogen, electrons of this hydrogen is going to be shifting. That can be written as this carbon H plus then double bond C H H H then C H H like this we can be written has eight more structures we can be written because it's totally how many hydrogen atoms are there that is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 here I written two structures then it can be written as remaining seven structures seven more structures we can be written like this means here this that is a hyperconjugation effect is going to be stabilizes the tertiary carbocation then next it is also be stabilizes the free radical it also stabilizes the free radicals. That is, if you are going to be in order, that is tertiary free radical is more stable than the secondary free radical. Secondary free radical is more stable than the primary free radical. Primary free radical is more stable than the middle free radical. How means we are going to get the more structures in the tertiary free radicals. And write the free radical structure of the that is the tertiary free radical. This is about the tertiary free radical. Then the shifting of permanent displacement of the electrons. Then we are going to be get the structure that is the C double bond C H H then hydrogen free radical then C H H then C H H. This is about the like this only we get that eight more structures means it's going to be stabilizes the hyperconjugation is the reason for the stabilizing the carbocations and the free radical in this order. This is about the next class we'll discuss about the purification methods on the organic compounds. The organic compounds na yavatara purify madabodu anna next class alli discuss madta.